Hello friends, welcome on this video tutorial. Daniel is here from Tips to Fix, and in this video today I will talk about this great software is MiniTool ShadowMaker. If you were searching for a software to backup your Windows 11 on external hard drive or SSD drive or USB or something, but you wanted to do this process for free, then here it is, MiniTool ShadowMaker. I like the company, I like MiniTool, okay? They do very great softwares I've used before. But now we have here MiniTool ShadowMaker. I see this software includes a lot of options inside, and this is the reason why I thought, okay, let's do this review and see this software, and it will backup your Windows 11 or clone your hard drive for free. That's great, okay? If you want to install it for free, just go here on a MiniTool website, click free download, and here it is. You will see here the setup, and open up, install it now. I will reinstall the program, no problem for me. Okay, let's start now. Nice, MiniTool ShadowMaker. Okay, here it is. Set up a backup. I will try. Let's set up a backup. I use this external hard drive. I have here an SSD drive, and what I gotta do, I will connect with my extender. I will bring it here and let's see. Okay, and also I have a new USB drive that I will use for backup. Okay, here it is. We have backup here. Choose your source, okay? And destinations is very important. And in the source will be hard drive that you wanted to copy files from, okay? Disk and partitions, great! Okay, I will clone this one here. Because I need to have, let's have this backup. Okay. You don't have that much space. I will choose my USB, click OK. And backup now. Now, okay. And it will start backing up. And now let's backup files. Try to backup some files and folders, okay? Some MP3 music, okay? And I will backup here on this USB. Backup now, and it will start to backup the files. You see the log file here, you see manage, you see the restore. If you wanted to restore, you can restore it directly from here. Synchronize, you can try to synchronize folders. Everything that you copy on this folder will be cloned in the other folder. Choose the destination. I will be here in the USB. Everything that I do on this folder now, click sync. And it will be on the background, okay? You can delete if you don't need it anymore, okay? And everything that I do on the folder, it will be synchronized on my USB drive. That's great if you need this tool for your work. And if you have a folder in desktop and you need to clone or to synchronize this folder in your USB drive, and everything you do on the folder, it will be cloned on your USB. This is really good feature, okay? Another thing that I wanted to show to you is this, clicking here on the tools, really nice option here is this media builder. You can make your MiniTool media builder on your USB drive, and then if you have any problem with your computer, you will boot up your computer from this software, MiniTool media builder, and then you will have the privilege to restore all Windows data and everything that you have on your external hard drive. Choose your flash drive here, and this start to build the USB boot disk. So it's starting to make this USB bootable. So you see this is done, click finish here, and now we have a bootable USB drive. But if you don't want to use your USB, you can create a boot menu. That's another option. And click yes here. Okay, the bot menu has been added successfully and click OK. Exit. Now we have a boot menu. Okay, let's restart the computer and see here. We will choose MiniTool recovery environment. So using MiniTool ShadowMaker on a bootable mode, you have to have pro license for that. Using that option is not for free, so we don't need that. So, and let's go here again to tools and add boot menu and then delete boot menu. Click yes, then that's it. Now, you don't have to see that pop up again, okay? If you want to clone this hard drive to this SSD drive, you can use this software and you can clone. Choose your source hard drive, let's say this one, and then choose the target hard drive and then click OK. So I don't need to do this now. And these three options are for pro software, but we have bunch of options here. We don't need to buy this software for the moment. So this is how this software works. And so this is how this software works, guys. Thank you for watching this video tutorial. If you have any questions, just write me a comment on a comment area. Give it a try, test it, and let me know if this software works well for you. So thank you for watching this video. God bless you. See you on the next video tutorial.